everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Today's matchup should be interesting. The Titans are top 10 in first downs, and they'll be up against the Ravens team that wants to be able to control the pace. Set for the call of this Week 15 matchup, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We welcome all of you to Nissan Stadium on the banks of the Cumberland River in downtown Nashville, Tennessee. Today, we reach Week 15, and we've got a good matchup in store between the Baltimore Ravens and the Tennessee Titans. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. In motion left goes a tight end. Now they'll run it on the toss. And it'll work his way across the 30 to the 32. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge, whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end, in the direction they want to run the football? If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a game. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
And this one caught by Max Williams. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. They were ready for what the defense was showing. They had prepared for that look, recognized it, went straight to the air, got the first. Well done.
Love the recognition, because you can prepare for everything. You can watch the tape and put together your game plan, but you still have to understand what they're doing in terms of what they're showing and be able to adjust accordingly, and they did exactly that.
And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first, but if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field, and when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And some room to roam now. Past the 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A big play there. His 19th touchdown now on the season. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. And the Ravens lead it 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Fourth-year man from Texas A&M, Christian Michael. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They go to Michael again. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
But we always talk about good down and distance, allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down.
Check. Patriot! Let's go!
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field.
And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
And he stopped immediately there. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? And almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. How about that?
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. They'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Third and 20, and no surprise, the defense in the dime. Third and long here for Mariota. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
You know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities. Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
And Michael fumbles it. Fumbled the football. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back. But it will be a loss on the play. So third and two, and I count six defensive backs out there. They'll look to throw here. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down. Here's Brad Wing now to punt it away on fourth down. Oh, it's a wobbler here. Not good at all. Punt of just 24 yards there. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. Here comes the Raven offense now ready for another possession. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
A look at the defensive starters for Tennessee.
Earl Thomas is the rangiest free safety in the game. Great reactions, great understanding, and boy, will he strike you when the ball's in his area.
Second down, Mariota shreds the tackle. Man open left side, it's Williams. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
An extra defensive back in the game now here for third and four. Mariota now. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now.
I would say so, and they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots, but what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
And how about this wide receiving core, Charles?
Well, I was at the hotel watching a little film, and you popped your head in and said, these receivers are pretty good from what I can tell. You're exactly right. Can't wait to see them do their thing out on the field.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The starters now defensively for Baltimore.
C.J. Mosley's your prototypical Alabama linebacker. They'll come downhill and smack you, but they understand the game so well.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he finds his target. It's Sharp. Well, we saw the practice film this week. They wanted to focus on these intermediate passing plays, and it paid off there.
And they took that focus not just to the practice field, but in the film room to show the guys exactly what they wanted, what types of looks they should expect to get, and how they would beat those coverages each and every time. And it paid off on that play.
Let's go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Solid run down inside the 30. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Not an ideal spot to be on first down, but I love that the play caller did not immediately abandon the running game and say, okay, we've got to throw it in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Got a man right side. It's Sharp. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. With the former Volunteer Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. On the give, this is their fullback. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Just a gain of a yard, but it's going to set him up with a first and goal.
Let's face it, you always want a team full of guys who can get you first downs and big plays of all styles. But you've got to have a big man. You can just turn and hand it to him, and he can be dependable in picking up first downs.
They'll look to throw here. Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Tajay Sharp, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Ravens offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Little motion now from the tight end. Now a handoff here to his running back. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd-and-2 situation.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? when the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
They'll try and run for it. This is Juszczyk. And he's got some space here. And all the way down to the 26. Smart approach there, using the run to pick up the first. And that was a defensive setup they prepared for this week, knowing that keeping it on the ground was the best way to attack it.
And that means also that they're able to read them pretty well. All the things they prepared for, when they get to the line of scrimmage, they see it in pre-snap recognition and know exactly how to attack based on their planning and preparation.
Oh, he's got a little daylight. And eventually brought down, but it's near the 5 at the 6. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
I'm still an old school football guy, and anytime you see a big time running play, that fires me up. And if I'm on offense right now, in the position they're in now, inside the 10-yard line, I think after the way they've run it, they've set themselves up for a good play action pass opportunity right here.
They come out here in the eye. First and goal. Defense with their backs against the wall. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He was trying to get his second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier. Was bidding for a second. Now they'll run it on the toss. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
They're knocking on the door as they come to the line here on third and goal from the 1. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. A great effort there with touchdown number 20 on the year. And the Ravens have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This fielded at the 2. And he's going to be out of bounds here as the run back will leave him shy of the 20-yard line. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. And the offense lining up first and 10.
Here we go now.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get 2, maybe 3 up near the 37.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run, because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
So they run it on second down. Now let's see what third down brings here for the offense. On third down, it's Michael. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and 1, you know the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
They'll drop the throw. Complete to Amaro on the right side. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys, we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Left side call by Diggs. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20.
And those first downs do add up. The offense keeps the ball moving downfield and keeps their defense on the bench, giving them a chance to rest.
Remain here in the first half. Back to Tennessee after this.
Detroit! Detroit! Now let's go! Green 39!
They'll look to throw now on first down. And he's caught right at the 10-yard line. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
This offense is in rhythm now, just accumulating first downs and moving the ball downfield.
Let's go!
Back to throw again. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be second and goal. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Stephon Diggs, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And oh, he missed it. No good. And they'll remain down by a point. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. This one taken from the 7. And some space here. Trotty. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver. 92 yards. And the Ravens will extend their lead. Such an electric play, so much fun to watch, and you need all 11 guys in sync for that to be successful, don't you?
Without a doubt. That's teamwork, to be able to put it all together, but that play is really probably the most exciting 10 seconds in football.
This fielded at the 2. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
Tajay Sharp, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Now they'll throw here out of the gun, finding time. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. So still a full 10 yards to go here for the offense on third down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
And definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Fielded just inside the 30. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And possession will change here with very little time remaining until halftime.
Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Now a second down throw for Mariota. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So here we go, first and 10 now. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking deep downfield. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Second and 5. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve, and that's what they did on that play. They went there, but the defense still made an excellent play and held them to no gain.
Let's go!
Out of the gun now on third down. And he finds his target. It's Sharp. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
And he'll get this across midfield to the 48. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and 1.
And that's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And, you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
Looking to throw. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. They'll look to throw for it on third and 1. And he's able to find Diggs.
15 yards through the air on a first down.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even added a little extra at the end with a short run.
So second and 10 here.
No. Check. Patriot. Let's go.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. Here's a carry heading left. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
Second down, Mariota. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
You circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock.
Play action now. Mariota. It's caught inside the 25. And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
And the D looking like they may blitz. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. A great play there. His 21st touchdown of the season. And the Ravens will add on to their lead. And the lead is up to 15 now. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better. Now, that's a run that warms a play caller's heart because you're actually set up to do whatever you want on offense. You can come right back and run essentially the same play because you have momentum. or you can fake that running play and throw something deep over the top. Or you now feel like you have an extra down to play with, because if you go ahead and just throw it and you don't get it, come back and try and pick it up on third down.
At 5 yards on the play there, it's a drive will continue.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
All right, here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. All right, here we go. 3-19.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
Let's go.
While there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this 3rd quarter as he'll go for it on 4th down. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And it is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
Let's see if they dial it up this drive. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. So he loses 3 yards there. Now 3rd down.
Partner, I think there's a lesson there. Some days you're just having a really tough time, and for the defense, today has been that day. But after that play, what do you learn? You can still make plays even when the other guy's having success against you.
A dime look defensively here for the Titans on 3rd. To throw is Mariota. And is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. Out come the Titans now. And this offense, last time turned it over, went for it on 4th, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Here we go now.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Now
Back now in Nashville. They come up in an offset eye. Now they'll run it on the toss. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And they get 10 yards there and convert on third.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. He'll get about 6 there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line.
Good, strong run against the 3-4 set. And that 3-4, you've got to have you guys up front eat up a lot of blocks. The guy playing over the center, the nose, he usually has to take on double teams. But when you're able to successfully move him, you're often able to get some yardage. And that's when linebackers have to clean up and make tackles.
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. He lost 2 there. And it's third down. They got to get it to the 21 here on third down. Now a handoff as they run left side. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. And that rushing touchdown is 4th, puts him just 1 shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it. But he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This fielded at the 2. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's brought down after a good game. That one goes for 24 yards.
One of the good things offenses did years ago was they lettered their gaps the same on each side. A gap between guard and center on either side. That's what you want to control when you're trying to run the ball up the middle.
And why is that?
Because typically you either have a big nose guard in there in an odd front, three-man front, or you have defensive tackles that might line up in the A-gap trying to gain an advantage and get upfield themselves. If you can control that, it gives the back plenty of space to pick and choose where to go.
And there, a great inside run broke the contact and got some space. Second down now after the pass completion. Shift together here from the D-line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down. 3rd down now following the completed pass.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you throw a lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down. No gain on that run, and while the team is down, there's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I've got to think about moving at a faster pace and maybe opening things up a little bit and throwing it a little bit more.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And this is caught at the 8. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. And the 8th play on this drive coming up. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense, so you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they showed to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
They got to have 6 here. It's third and goal. They'll let the fullback try and take him home. What a stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a 4th and goal. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Maybe one final chance here to make this a bit more respectable, as he'll go for it on 4th and goal.
Let's go! Blue line!
Gotta try it here. He's back. And he is gonna go down. Back at the 11-yard line. Hayes Pollard in there to drop him. And it'll be a loss of about 8. And the Ravens taking the field. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League. You're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment. And to do it this convincingly, that just tears up the script that every home team has, which is nobody comes in our house and pushes us around. They took care of business today.
Yeah, they pushed around, and now the final stages of this one. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. Now they'll run it on the toss. No gain that time, and it leaves him with 3rd and 11 coming up.
Well, it was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
On 3rd down, Mariota, and Davis has it over the middle. The 13 yards that time of the first. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. It'll be a loss of 1, and it's going to be 3rd down and a ways to go here. 3rd and 14. Go on the ground. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So for the Ravens, It's a 10th win of the year now as they move to 10-4. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Houston Texans. Meanwhile, for Tennessee, the season is really nosediving now as they fall to 2-12. And they'll be on the road next week as they get a date with the Jaguars in Jacksonville. So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we sign off from Nashville.